We have the documentary, the Steven Johnson Syndrome documentary, which is about a young lady named Jean Powe. She was misdiagnosed with hives and given, I'm trying to remember the name, a cyclovir, 800 milligrams to take 4 to 5 times a day. And she had a severe allergic reaction after taking the medication. Her story is, it's sad. I mean, at sometimes, at one point, I think she told me she hadn't been out the house in like 6 years. You know, and sometimes we take for granted. We just jump up, run down the steps, run to the store, go to work, go to school, you know, do whatever it is you do, go socialize. She's laying in a bed and she's hearing people, you know, getting in their cars and running around and playing and walking and leaving the house. And she can't do those things. So, you know, this video, part of this video, it's to get her some justice and even spread awareness about Steven Johnson syndrome. Because, I mean, for the most part, if you ask somebody, they really don't know anything about Steven Johnson syndrome. Hello, my name is Stephen Laws and I'm in downtown Los Angeles. I recently found out a friend of mine, Jean Powe, has Steven Johnson syndrome, SJS. Steven Johnson syndrome is a severe allergic reaction to medication. I've come downtown to ask some random people if they've ever heard of Steven Johnson syndrome. Because until I talked with my friend Jean Powell, I had never heard of Steven Johnson syndrome. So we're going to take a trip. We're going to speak to some of these random people downtown and ask them, have you ever heard of Steven Johnson syndrome? Bam.
Okay, so brothers, I want to ask y'all a question. Have y'all ever heard of Steven Johnson syndrome?
Steven Johnson syndrome,
Have you ever heard of Steven Johnson syndrome?
No.
I'm shooting a documentary on Steven Johnson syndrome. Have you ever heard of that?
No.
Have you ever heard of Steven Johnson syndrome?
No.
Have you ever heard of Steven Johnson syndrome?
I've never heard of it.
Have you ever heard of Steven Johnson syndrome?
No, I have not.
Have you ever heard of Steven Johnson syndrome?
I think so. I couldn't tell you exactly what it is, though.
Have you guys ever heard of Steven Johnson syndrome?
No.
What's the syndrome?
Steven Johnson syndrome.
What is that?
Have you ever heard of Steven Johnson syndrome?
Can't say I have.
Have you ever heard of Steven Johnson syndrome?
No, I haven't.
Steven Johnson syndrome. Have you ever heard of Steven Johnson syndrome?
No.
Have you ever heard of Steven Johnson syndrome?
Not really, no.
I'm doing a documentary on Steven Johnson syndrome. Have you ever heard of that?
Nope.
Steven Johnson syndrome. Have you ever heard of that?
No.
Have you ever heard of Steven Johnson syndrome?
No, I haven't.
Sir, have you ever heard of Steven Johnson syndrome?
No.
Have you guys ever heard of Steven Johnson syndrome?
No.
Have you ever heard of Steven Johnson syndrome?
To be honest with you, I haven't, bro.
Have you ever heard of Steven Johnson syndrome?
No.
If you go to Steven Johnson syndrome and look at the photos, oh, it's just horrible. And it's thousands of people. You just don't hear about it. That's why I'm glad you guys are doing this, because the awareness. We just need to be heard, because this disease is really serious. It's real serious. That's why I always try to spread awareness about it and tell people about it, because it could happen to you or anybody. They claim it's rare, but it's not rare. It's happened to too many people. I mean, in every city, there's thousands of people. It's been around since the 1900s, that long. Just don't hear. I never heard of it until it happened to me. I had never heard of it, but I read about it. The name Steven Johnson is Dr. Stevens, Dr. Johnson. They found it in babies way back in the 1900s. Babies were given these medications where they would have these major allergic reactions to the medicine. So they named it, the two doctors, Dr. Steven, Dr. Johnson, they named their findings Steven Johnson syndrome.
Another disease taking over the nation. The Steven Johnson syndrome situation. S.J.S. is the abbreviation of the skin inflammation caused by medications. We need more foundations in awareness of S.J.S. and its severity. So I'm hoping someone hears this and shares this so that we're fearful, not fearless, and careful, not careless of the rarest. Disease that'll have you looking like a monster. The symptoms of the syndrome must be checked and monitored during early stages before it gets outrageous but not contagious. SJS is still dangerous, like a combo of psoriasis and dermatitis. So I write this to fight this terminal virus and do what's righteous. That's why God made us, to fade the haters that plague us with SJS. Educate before you medicate. Let's pray for us.
My name is Jean Powe. I just turned 61 in May. I was born in Mobile, Alabama, and I currently live in Los Angeles today. Okay. Well, I had a real good childhood. My grandparents raised me. My mother was there, but she left there, came to Los Angeles to make a way for me and her. But I would come back and forth to see her. Every year, and when I got about 11, I came and lived here for good in Los Angeles. I went to Catholic school when I was younger, St. Agatha, Martin Luther, Heart of Mary, and when I came to Los Angeles, I went to public school, Palms Junior High, and from Palms, I went to Dorsey High School. And then I went to Los Angeles City College. No, the last job I had was I ran a liquor store in a deli.
Steven Johnson syndrome is a severe allergic reaction to medication. It's like your body is burning up from the inside out. You can get Steven Johnson syndrome from taking simple medication like Tylenol, Motrin, ibuprofen. Have y'all ever taken any of those?
Yeah, I just drink water, bro.
Just drink water, okay.
Yeah, I took some though.
It's a severe allergic reaction to medication. You can get it from taking Tylenol. You ever take Tylenol?
Yeah.
Motrin?
Yeah.
Ibuprofen?
Yeah.
Okay, let me back this up then.
I haven't heard of that term, but I have that. I can't take no ibuprofen, man. Mm-hmm. It'll swell me up.
Stevens Johnson syndrome is a severe allergic reaction to medication. People get it from taking ibuprofen, Motrin or Tylenol. Have you ever taken any of those?
I have taken those.
It's a severe allergic reaction to medication. You can get it from taking Tylenol, ibuprofen, Motrin. It's like your body burns up from the inside out. Have you ever taken any of those drugs?
Yeah.
Stevens Johnson syndrome is a severe allergic reaction to medication. You can get it from taking Tylenol, ibuprofen, Motrin, and a lot of other medications. Have you guys ever taken any of that?
Yeah.
Steven Johnson syndrome is a severe allergic reaction to medication.
Okay.
You can get it from taking Tylenol, ibuprofen, Motrin, and a host of other medications. Have you ever taken any of those?
Yes.
It's a severe allergic reaction to medication. You can get it from taking Tylenol, ibuprofen, Motrin. Have you ever taken any of those?
Yes.
You gotta educate before you medicate. Thank you a lot. It's a severe allergic reaction to medication, which you can get from taking Tylenol, ibuprofen, or Motrin, or a host of other medications. Have you ever taken any of those?
I took Advil yesterday.
Advil, you can get it from Advil. You have to educate before you medicate. That's the goal. We want to say educate before we medicate about Steven Johnson syndrome, and we want to create awareness. Can you say help create awareness?
Help create awareness.
Okay. I think it was traumatic for everybody, because it makes my family and certain friends, the ones that don't come around, their excuses. People say they don't have time or they don't want to see me like this. My thing is like what? I'm the same person. I have the same mind. I may not look like that person, but it does affect not only me, but it affects everybody around me. People look at you different, I notice, and they don't. Oh, I don't know what to say about people. My family, they've been with me ever since this happened to me. And friend, you lose. Well, if you may know, when something happens to you or you become bedridden, it shows you who is who and what is what. You lose a lot of friends. They may still be there, but they're not here. You know, it's not a physical thing. It's sad. God, I was so outgoing. They used to call me a jet setter, a resort queen. I've been to so many resorts, it's ridiculous. But I love to party, though. You know, I went to clubs, and I loved to dance then. And that's it, parties, dance, and dinner engagements are, I like the ballet. And, so many things. I did a lot of my family dinner engagements, stuff like that. Me and my mother used to do a lot together when I was up and walking. Yeah. The only condition I had was rheumatoid arthritis. I've had it since 11, but from 11 years old to about 11, that was 69. In the 80s, I had a knee surgery on this knee. I had to have a total reconstructive knee surgery. And after that surgery, I haven't had no arthritis problems, no pain, no nothing anymore. Yeah.
It's a severe allergic reaction to medication, like Advil, Tylenol, ibuprofen, Motrin. Have you ever taken any of those?
Yeah, sure.
Okay, we're trying to create awareness that you got to educate before you medicate.
What's great about taking herbals? It's better, right?
It's much better because it's natural.
Natural, taking
natural, some... Natural, you don't take chemicals. They don't cause any side effects.
Okay. So do you have something, if I said something in place of maybe ibuprofen or a Tylenol, would you have something for me?
Yeah. We have, similar products to what you can find over the counter in a regular pharmacy. And they work just like those, but without the side effects.
Without the side effects, they're natural. And you are? Where are we at?
We are at Natural Sunshine.
And you guys come to his store, and you come here and you buy some natural medications, and I hope you buy all of the stuff that he has and be very healthy.
Yeah, because, I mean, you know, just look at your pets. When they feel sick, what do? Call the doctor?
They eat grass?
They go to the plants. Okay. So why can't we do the same thing?
You ever take Tylenol, Motrin, ibuprofen, Advil?
And then I answer, I'm a healthy man, thank God.
I bet your ladies and women you know in your life take those medications. They have to educate.
I have an answer. I will have to ask them that question in order to answer that question.
They must educate before they medicate. So we're trying to create awareness. Can you say create awareness?
They're the ones.
Okay. Stephen Johnson syndrome is severe allergic reaction to medication.
Yep.
You get it from ibuprofen, Tylenol, Motrin, Advil. You guys said you may have taken some of that before.
Yeah.
So SJS is the acronym for it. Severe allergic reaction to medication. It's like your body is on fire from the inside out. You slob. Stevens Johnson syndrome is a severe allergic reaction to medication. You can get it if you take Tylenol, Advil, ibuprofen, Motrin. Have you ever taken any of those?
Yeah.
It's a very bad thing. It's called Stevens Johnson syndrome. It's like your body burns up from the inside out. It's a lot of bad things. Some people end up blind from it. So I'm doing a documentary to educate and create awareness for Stevens Johnson syndrome. It's a severe allergic reaction to medication. Have you ever taken Tylenol, Advil, ibuprofen, Motrin?
Yeah.
When you get Stevens Johnson syndrome, it's rare, but it's almost like your body is burning up from the inside out. I'm doing a documentary on a lady who was stricken with Stevens Johnson syndrome, and her life was ruined. Not only was her life ruined, but her mother's life was ruined, because her mother, she's like a baby now. She's bedridden, she's in pain, she hears people outside playing, she can't walk, she can't get up. Imagine not being able to go out and jump up and go to work. go play, go out with your significant other and have some fun or something. You know, so she's been bedridden. So I'm trying to create awareness for Steven Johnson syndrome. So we're telling people to educate before you medicate.
Do you want to say something on the camera?
Do what?
You want to say anything on the camera?
About what?
About, you know, what you do to take care of Jane?
Oh, no, that would take a whole year to take care of you. That's around the clock thing.
You sure?
My duty start with Jean.
Can I get a little video of you?
My duty start with Jean at 6:30 in the morning and end somewhere at night after 12 p.m. That it's a round the clock thing. The same as in the hospital. But I'm just not, and especially if she said it's at the beach. Mm-hmm. That means it's going to entail walking. I'm not able to do the walking. I'm going to the doctor hoping, he's going to have to give me a prescription so I can do some physical therapy. Hope I can get my back in shape so I can at least walk. You get me on the camera?
Yes, ma'am.
What?
You want to see yourself?
No.
I can flip it around. You can see yourself.
Oh my God! Don't let nobody see me on camera. I look terrible.
I think you look great.
You
look great.
You know, it's a problem getting Jane out of here.
Yeah. I see the steps. She was saying that she got to get carried everywhere, and I see that's a test.
She has to have two strong men to get her. You know, she has to be lifted. Put in the she got to be lifted. She got to be two strong, heavy people, you know, to get her in the car. And then she wants to stay someplace and stay all night. She don't want to come back. So I got to find somebody to, you know, take care of her at night. She have to have nurse duty. See, she got to have everything have to be done for her. The only movement Jean has is with her two little arms. And she don't have that much movement with her arms.
Mm-hmm.
She can't sit up, she can't stand up, you know, but she can't be left no place by herself. Mm-hmm. Wake up in the morning, I got to start from head to toe, brush teeth, wash face, bathe, clean butt, pee-pee, go to the bathroom, feed her, wash her, bathe her, you know, same with a baby.
Okay.
So it ain't like she goes to these functions, but you know, it's more to it than meets the eye. You know, and they have to be like my brothers come and help, you know, help me take care of her, you know, like nurse duty here. Mm-hmm. She was out at Rancho Los Amigos in the county hospital. The ambulance drivers come in, you know, the ambulance man handle her.
Mm-hmm.
They wrap her up in a sheet, have the board there, and drag her down in the sheet, throw her on the board, and throw her up in the ambulance. And that's a hard job, because she's heavy. She diddle, but she's heavy.
She's got a little weight on her, huh?
No, it ain't the weight. It's the, you know, it's just dead weight. You know, she's heavy. And then the other problem, her back doesn't bend. You know, her back is like a bulwark.
Mm-hmm. Oh, her back. I thought she could sit up, so she can't sit up.
She can't do nothing.
Oh, I didn't know. I mean, if you sit up, can she sit up?
She can't do nothing.
But I mean, if you can sit up, she can sit up in like a chair?
She can't sit up.
Mm-hmm.
She can't sit up.
What about the blanket? You could roll the blanket up behind me and make a little.
Yeah, I know. It ain't enough of it back
there. Or it ain't.
DJ, remember the thing I took off?
Oh,
the little thing I stuffed in front? The little headrest I pulled off? DJ, let me grab a headrest. Let me see that. We might use that for something.
Yeah, the headrest could be a problem.
Because it's
the only thing I would worry about these pieces.
Looks like a pillow would be more comfortable, though.
A pillow?
Oh, he's
well,
a baby.
Well, not a pillow.
You want a pillow?
This is kind of
pillow.
Yeah, he's going to put my dress down.
You lay your head back on that, Jay.
Where is it at?
I'll put that under here.
That's good.
That's good.
My body put my dress down.
But you still got to... Yeah, remember one thing though, we move it.
Yeah, it's
going to so we move, yeah. So if you get a pillow,
so if, yeah, they got a pillow,
more,
better.
Even if you move it, it'll still be good. You know what I'm saying?
You said this is good though.
Yeah, this is good.
We just worry about it moving
but
though.
See, but if you move, I'm not going to move.
Okay.
Okay.
Carmen.
Yeah.
You got
that's
my
good.
Purse in my shoe.
Yeah, here are your shoes.
Put them right here.
Okay, on the floor, right? On the, down, on the bottom.
Yeah,
you
could
oh wow.
Turn the
coat
on the wrong.
She's up
side.
In there.
We're on our way to the 2016 Showbiz Mixer.
Yeah.
We're gonna talk to them about the documentary we're doing for Gene Powell. Gene Powell surviving. Steven Johnson Syndrome Survivor.
Okay.
And right now we're just showing all of the energy and energy and time and stuff it takes to get Gene from place to place. You can see from upstairs in her apartment through her bedroom, down here in the vehicle. And so part of this documentary is to help her get funding to get a nice house that's already handicapped, equipped, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. Bam.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, see, this show you don't take your mobility for granted.
Yeah.
Okay.
When she gets in the wheelchair.
Right about that. Right about that.
Steven Johnson syndrome, it's not a contagious disease. You get that by prescriptions given by a doctor. Antibiotics, ibuprofen, Advil. It could be any of those medications. And you have Steven Johnson syndrome. It's just a major allergic reaction to any medication given by a physician. I acquired it. I was out of town. I got bit by a spider, and I went to the hospital because my body broke out in hives. I had high fever, and I was throwing up. So when I got to the hospital, they looked at the hives, misdiagnosed my hives as shingles. They gave me medicine for shingles, acyclovir, 800 milligrams to take 5 times a day. And when I got back to L.A., I started taking this medicine. And the year that I got Steven Johnson syndrome was 2007, after taking the medication. It started making me feel real, real ill. Actually, I felt like I was dying. And it was Thanksgiving night. My family and everybody was in the room. I was in here getting dressed. And as I was coming into the room, I fell out. I don't remember nothing after that. And I woke up in Brockman Hospital. They had me in a room all to myself because Steven Johnson, it burns you from your head to the bottom of your feet. Your hair falls out, eyelashes, your eyes are swollen, just about shut. It blinds you, but I was lucky. Your whole body blisters from the inside out. It's like somebody set you on fire. And mine wasn't as severe as others. I do have pictures. My stomach was toxic, poison. My throat was closed for 3 years. I couldn't eat food. For 3 years, they put a G-tube in my stomach. My mother had to feed me through a tube. She was my in-home care provider. And your skin actually falls off in pieces. Oh, it's just horrible.
What's that?
The stages it's of Steven Johnson is, you know, the blisters. Some people get blisters in the mouth. I didn't. You get blisters on your genitals. I didn't. Swollen lips. Your hair fall out. Stomach is poisoned. Throat so swollen where you can't swallow. Some people are blinded. And many have died. Babies all the way to adults. And it's chronic. It doesn't go away. It's chronic. So it'll come back, but you don't know when. It just come back, and hopefully it's not like it was in the beginning. Yeah.
It's a severe allergic reaction to medication.
What type of medication?
Advil, Tylenol, Motrin, ibuprofen, a host of others.
Ibuprofen.
I can't pronounce it right. But once you get it, it's like your body's on fire from the inside out. It's a lot of bad things that happen. And I'm trying to educate people, tell them you got to educate before you medicate. And I'm trying to help this lady named Jean Powell, fine sister, took some medication. It ruined her life. Not only that, it ruined her mother's life because her mother now has to take care of her.
Those medications that you just mentioned,
mm-hmm.
all those medications, they have to be taken on, you can't take them on an empty stomach. They'll just eat the lining of your stomach up.
She has she told me she got a, what they call it, when a hole in your stomach?
Yeah, of course, because, you know, women are always trying to be slim and on a diet and don't want to eat and all that.
Mm-hmm.
You've got to eat something first before you take those medications because they eat away at your insides, you see?
Yeah.
So you got to coat your stomach with something, some food, you know, you take a... eat a sandwich or, you know, take a few bites of something, and then you take those medications.
That's great. She said an ulcer, and that's like a hole or something in your stomach?
That's the same thing.
She got that. What she got. She got that, too. It's a severe allergic reaction to medication. You can get it from taking Motrin, Advil, ibuprofen, Tylenol. Have you ever taken any of those?
Take it all.
I'm here to tell you. You got to educate before you medicate. I have a friend, and she has what's called Stevens-Johnson syndrome, S.J.S. She's been bedridden. It ruined her life. It ruined her mother's life. It's just like she's a baby again. At a certain point, she hadn't been out the house in 6 years. Can you imagine not being able to get up and go where you want to go? But, you know, whenever we want someone, when she want to go somewhere, it takes at least 3 men to pick her up. She lives upstairs, put in the blanket, sheet, a gurney, carry her, put in the car, and everywhere you got to go. So she lost a lot of things. She lost friends, family, and everything. So what we want to do is create awareness for this condition and tell people to educate before you medicate. Because you don't want, you know, nobody else to be important like this. It's a medical condition. People get it when they take Tylenol, ibuprofen, Motrin, Advil. Have you ever taken any of those?
Yes, I have.
Stevens-Johnson syndrome is a severe allergic reaction to medication. You can get it from taking Tylenol, ibuprofen, Motrin, Advil, and a host of other things. It's like your body is on fire from the inside out. You can be bedridden. It can really jack you up. So we're doing this documentary on Stevens-Johnson syndrome to tell people you got to educate before you medicate. Can y'all help?
The doctor in the hospital, I was in Escondido, California when it happened. And it happened at, I went to Palomar Medical Center. That's where I was misdiagnosed, given the wrong medication. The doctor, well, I can't say her name, but she's no longer there. Actually, I had to get a process server to find her. After about 3 to 4 weeks in the hospital, I had about 5 doctors. They didn't know what it was. See, they said Stevens-Johnson syndrome is rare, but it's not rare. If you research it, you would be surprised how many people this has happened to, you know, given these prescriptions and this medication. It's happened to so many people. As a matter of fact, if you go on Facebook, you'll see Stevens-Johnson Syndrome Foundation by Jean McCauley, her and her daughter Julie. They speak out a lot about it. Jean McCauley, she's done a whole lot, you know, for people like me and others. Need a break.
Need a break?
Just talking about it and it makes me cry. It's like reliving the whole thing over. It was really bad.
I saw a portrait of a pretty face. Just a simple case. I mean, the picture was misplaced. Of leaning to the right side. So might I go set things straight? Just leaning to the right side.
side. So might I, go and say things strange. But I can't wait till I get inside on Monday. I can't get to the other side. Why? 'Cause it's Sunday. I saw a portrait of a pretty face. Just a simple case. I mean, the picture was misplaced. Of leaning to the right side. So might I go set things straight? Just leaning to the right side. So might I.
As far as the doctors and the hospitals that treated me, I don't like them. One thing, they've never stepped up to admit and say that they did this to me. As I tell, I didn't do this to myself. This was done to me, misdiagnosed with an illness that I didn't have. I've written to the medical board. So many attorneys, television stations, Oprah, Ellen, Robin Roberts, Sanjay Gupta, American Medical Association, Federal Drug Administration, New England Journal, I must have written close to about 65 people. I just wrote Ridley Thomas, councilman for my district, to ask him. I know they're busy, but when they have time, put it on the table. Take the cap off medical malpractice limitations. You know, it's people like me. I was sick during the whole time, so I couldn't speak out for myself. But when I tried to, it was too late. Statute of limitations had ran. It was too late for me. But I'm still fighting.
Oh, happy birthday, Gene. We in here at Marina Del Rey, El Toritos, celebrating Gene Powell's birthday. Me and Gene, I've been knowing her for quite a long time. 7.5 years, actually. And then we went out on a trip one day out to San Diego, had a real nice time and everything. And on the trip, we went out to one of them fruit stands and she got bit by a spider. So her arm started swelling up real bad, you know. So we went to the hospital down in San Diego. When we went there, we was in there for a little while, you know, and the doctor prescribed us some medication. It was real bad medication, you know, because he had a real bad adverse effects, you know, and her skin started peeling and everything, you know, and swelling up and everything, you know. And so because of that medication that they gave her the wrong medication. They gave her medication for shingles. She didn't have no shingles. So they automatically gave her the wrong medicine, you know. And then we found out later on that the doctor they gave it to her was an intern. So everything was all totally messed up because of what happened. She kind of had to put a halt on her life. We used to go on little trips all the time. We went to Vegas. We went to the mountains out there in I can't think of the Grand Canyon. Yeah, we went out there by Grand Canyon and stuff, you know. And we went on a lot of nice trips, you know, and it's the same that because of what happened, it affected our life, you know, it was real detrimental to her, you know. So I really feel bad for what happened and stuff, you know. But she needs to get paid because of what happened, you know. She's a strong soldier. And anyone, I wouldn't, you know, think about anybody that had to go through with it. I feel bad for them, you know. Hopefully nothing will ever happen like that to anybody.
I'd like to find an attorney that if he have the time to step up and overturn the statute of limitations on my case. Because see, my mother and another paralegal, they did the work on my case, but they could only do so much. And they couldn't get the doctors, but nobody to step up. See, if I'd had an attorney, I've never been represented really by an actual attorney. So, you know, they couldn't subpoena anybody or anything like that. So I've never had real representation. So that's why I'm that's what I'm fighting for now. It's hard. I don't know why it's so hard. Stephen Johnson is the hardest medical malpractice case to fight. So nobody wants to step up and just say, this is what I did to this person. My goal is to be heard. Make Stephen Johnson aware, just like cancer or diabetes. You know, they're on TV every day. We're never on TV. You never hear nothing about Stephen Johnson syndrome. And it's out there. The only time a person will step up is if it happened to them. But they won't say anything about it because this happened to a couple of celebrities. Manute Bol, the basketball player, he died from Stephen Johnson syndrome. It happened to Miley Cyrus. I was hoping she would say something about it, you know, awareness or something, but she didn't. It's never over. It's chronic. Every now and then, I may break out in a blister or the rash that Stephen Johnson, you know, it's wherever you were burned, you'll have a breakout under the skin. Like my legs, everything was burned, my face, but I have all new skin now. But if you look close, you see the dark. Can you see the darkness in some parts of my leg? Those are burns.
All these medications. No. You don't want to be full-blown with the unknown. Let me educate you on Stephen Johnson syndrome. This disease irritates your skin tone. Without medical help, you won't live long. It all starts with a sore throat and a fever. Take notes of the pain relievers. If you're feeling fatigued and you're catching the flu, realize the medications you're allergic to. It's true. Pharmaceutical and sofa drugs show the body no love. S.J.S. a real bone thug, all the above attacking your mucous membrane. With blisters, your whole body starts to change, separating the dermis from the epidermis, burning your flesh from the inside to the surface. Conjunctivitis is more painful than arthritis, comatose, while you're laying there lifeless, ulcers and lesions, barely breathing. Let S.J.S. be the reason, And now that we know the facts, let's all live healthy and keep our life on track. With words of wisdom to have an impact.
Oh, my healing process was traumatic. Because from the burns, it's so painful. You have to be washed and the skin scraped. And they put this cream on you. You constantly have to be moved back and forth. And you feel everything. It was very painful. It was very stressful. I never had stress in my life. I always had a good, happy life. But this was a very stressful time for me. So much as so, I have an ulcer now. And I got the ulcer in the hospital. It stressed me so bad. And as far as medication, I refuse to take anything other than Dexalant for my ulcer. Other than that, I don't take anything. I don't trust medications anymore.
Yeah. All right. Yeah. She took her medication. She died.
without any complications. S.J.S. was on its way. Blisters all over. The doctor came and told her she'll never be the same. Well, it's time to talk about it. It's never too late to speak the truth, change somebody's fate. Got to talk about it. Take time to educate. Get all the facts before you medicate. Ooh, yeah, yeah. Educate before you medicate. Ooh, yeah, yeah. Educate before you medicate.
My days was usually on a computer. I watch a lot of movies. Every now and then a friend will come by and, you know, we may have lunch or just sit and talk and whatever. My days are boring, you know, because you're just laying here. And I cry every day. It's not a day go by that I don't cry. Because, you know, I just lay here and I look out the window and I hear people and talking and laughing and getting in their cars. And it just makes me think about when I used to do that, but not no more.
My name is Elijah, and I want y'all to help create awareness for Steven Johnson Syndrome.
My name is Cody. I want to help create awareness for Steven Johnson Syndrome.
Create awareness for Steven Johnson Syndrome.
Create awareness for Steven Johnson Syndrome.
Oh, I can type. I write. I write up all my bills myself. I taught myself with two thumbs. I type with my thumbs. I write with my two thumbs. Yeah.
Create awareness for Steven Johnson Syndrome.
Create awareness.
Create awareness for Steven Johnson Syndrome.
Create awareness.
Thank you. Middle and last name, Steven Johnson Syndrome. I touched down in 1922, but I ain't talking handsome. Let me break it down just what I do. Had two doctor flu-like symptoms. I leave blisters purple, red, and blue, and disorder your system. Your skin and mucous membrane. With some medicator drive insane. Your skin gon' die, shed off. Your friends see that, they gon' head off. No ride to the house, they sped off. They cold as a pole bear up north. I'm not catchy, doctors can't catch me. I can pop up, but still they can't catch me. Even Yoda, if I was soda, couldn't tell if a Coke or I'm Pepsi. Tell somebody, I'm Brad, I'm not your pet. A misdiagnosis, a diagnosis, I'm S.J.S. Come and get me, so elusive. You better educate before you medicate, it's true. What Doc prescribe or store for vital verb counters to you. Might be severe, your body acting, Doc ain't got a clue. You burn it from the inside out, he said you got the flu. What's your first name? Last name? Steven Johnson Syndrome. I just damn 1922. I ain't talking ends on, let me break it down. What I do, had two to flu-like symptoms. I believe blisters, purple, red, and blue, and disorder your system.
Started complications. S.J.S. was on its way. Blisters all over. The doctor came and told her she'll never be the same. Well, it's time to talk about it. It's never too late to speak the truth, change somebody's fate. got to talk about it. Take time to educate. Get all the facts before you medicate. Ooh, yeah, yeah. Educate before you medicate. Ooh, yeah, yeah. Educate before you medicate.
Yo, like I said, we've been shooting the documentary. Hey, yo, I'm shooting a documentary. Can y'all say educate before you medicate?
Yeah, educate. Educate before you medicate.
Educate before you medicate.
Educate before you medicate.
Look at my website, by any means music. By any means music.com.